So this is the Maxus eDeliver 3 electric van. These are also called the Maxus or LDV EV30 in other markets. And in this video, I'm just going to show you how you open the charge port at the front and also how you release a charge cable. So the charge port at the front of the vehicle does lock. So if you come up to it and give it a little push and it's not releasing, it's not opening, it's likely that it's simply locked. So using your keys, if you unlock the vehicle, give it a little push, then it will open. So with these charge ports, the secret is push directly in the middle of the badge in this area here. So give that a push with the palm of your hand, and then that is enough to release it. And again, to lock it, just push it in the middle of the emblem. That's a release, that's a lock. So when you open the charge port, you pull it all the way up. You do have to sort of bend down to see your charge ports here, and at the top there is a rubber bung covering your type 2 AC charging port, and then when you need to DC rapid charge, there is a second bung there covering your CCS port. And then when putting these back in, you need to put them back in order. The CCS goes in first, and then the type 2 with the flat surface at the top goes in second, because that overlaps the bottom one. While looking under here, the other thing just to make a note of is there's two little rubber bungs, one there and one there, and they have a habit of falling out and going missing. They're absolutely tiny, they only stick out by about 3 millimeters. They don't make a huge difference to the operation of the charge port there, but it's worth just knowing that they exist and keeping an eye on yours, because if they're about to fall out, even if they drop out in front of you, they're so tiny, they're difficult to find if you're on rough ground. So yeah, there's only two, but they just act like a little buffer. But if they're lost, it's not the end of the world. The charge port still operates just fine without them. So next, I'm just going to talk about your AC charging cable here. So if I plug that in, the van will start charging in a second, and there's a little locking pin that locks the cable in. So that's now charging, and we've got a green flashing light there to show it's charging. And your charge cable is locked into the vehicle, as it is on all electric vehicles. So obviously that stops anyone unplugging your vehicle and obviously stealing your cable as well. So the locking of this is simply done on the central locking. So when you come to release your charging cable, you just need to unlock the vehicle, and you'll hear the little pin slide there, and then you can pull that out. But you need to do that within a few seconds. If you have unlocked your vehicle and then you take more than a few seconds to come and release that cable, it's going to lock itself again and continue charging. So if you come to the vehicle and you can't get the cable out, just simply press unlock again, and then you can remove it. So if for some reason you can't release this, I think the only scenario where that would be the case is if the battery has gone flat in your key fob and this isn't working and that locking pin is still locked, then there is an emergency release under the bonnet, which I'll show you now. So you need to open the bonnet, which means getting in the van. So if this key has gone flat, then you can of course use the old-fashioned blade to get inside the van, no problem at all. And then you need to release the bonnet. So you next have got to open the bonnet, so you need to push this charge flap down to give you as much access as you can there. Get your fingers under there and release that bonnet catch. So as an owner of one of these vans, you will know that the bonnet isn't hinged, but you will be able to just lift it up on those corners, just don't damage the paint, just enough to get to that release cable there. But because it's a bit awkward, I'm doing this one-handed, I'm holding a camera here, I'm going to rip the bonnet off. And then at the front here, this is your emergency release to release that charge cable. So all you need to do, pull the emergency release cable. That's then stopped charging. I think that still stays locked. It does. So come back here, release it a second time. You can then get your cable out. And then you're going to want to put in your bung, make sure they're both pushed in tight, put the charge flap down, and then give it a push right in the centre of the badge there. I found with these Maxus vans, sometimes some of them, these are quite awkward and require a bigger push than this one does. This one actually works quite well, but I've had some where they really do take quite a bit of a push. And what I found, when they are particularly stiff, what might help is just using your leg there with your fist in the middle of the badge and using your body weight on it. So it just gets it in that right place. But there doesn't seem to be any adjustment on these. And looking at this, it looks like that is your locking catch there. So maybe a bit of lubrication on that plastic pin might help. And just making sure it's all clean, because this does collect the dirt, because it's right at the front of the vehicle. They do get dirty. So just make sure all these pins, pivot pins and things, are all nice and clean and free from dirt. So that's it for this one. Hope that helps. If it has, please do click that thumbs up button on YouTube. That really does help, and it helps other people find this channel. If you want to know more about these vans, the Maxus eDeliver 3, I've put a link in the video description below to a playlist where you can watch more videos I've made on these vans. Do subscribe if you're not, and I'll see you on the next video.